In this demonstration, we will introduce you to the NASA Earth Observing System Data and Information System, or EOSDIS Worldview Imagery Mapping and Visualization application. This tool provides the capability to interactively browse over 1,000 global full-resolution satellite imagery layers. Many of these layers are updated daily and are available within 3 hours of observation. Also available are geostationary imagery layers, which are provided in 10-minute increments for the last 90 days. These full disk hemispheric views allow for almost real-time viewing of changes occurring around most of the world, essentially showing the entire Earth as it looks right now. Worldview also has imagery dating back to February 2000, with daily observations from the Moderate Resolution Imaging Spectral Radiometer, or MODIS instrument, aboard NASA's Terra satellite. Worldview's easy-to-use map interface lets you interactively explore NASA Earth science imagery to see hurricanes forming, wildfire spreading, icebergs drifting, and city lights illuminating. So let's get started. First, we'll go to Worldview by typing in worldview.earthdata.nasa.gov into the browser, like I've already done. When Worldview first loads, you'll see a window welcoming you to Worldview. This window contains an array of tour stories where you can learn about how to use Worldview to explore events happening around the world. Let's click on the Introduction to Worldview tour story, which provides a general overview of the different elements of the Worldview tool. Click on the pulsing orange dot to start, and as we go through the tour, you'll get an overview of the different features and buttons within the application. First up are the Layers, Events, and Data tabs on the left side. Click Next to proceed through the tour. The layer list shows all the imagery layers that are loaded on the map. The Events tab shows a curated list of current and historical natural events around the world. The Data tab allows you to download the underlying data. The Add Layers button opens the layer picker that allows you to browse and search over 1,000 satellite imagery layers. The Start Comparison button allows you to compare imagery. The Date selector is in the lower left corner where you can change the date, and next to it is the Interval selector so you can increment the dates by your desired interval. Next is the Video Camera icon, which opens the Animation tool. The Timeline Layer Coverage panel can be accessed via the double chevrons above the timeline. It allows you to see whether imagery is temporally coincident. The Time Scale Zoom on the bottom right allows you to adjust the time scale between the years, months, and days, and hours and minutes if you have a geostationary layer loaded. Directly above the time scale zoom are the map coordinates. You can change between common coordinate formats here and see which coordinate system you are using. The ruler icon initiates the measure tool, where you can measure distances and areas in miles or kilometers. Moving to the top right of the app, you can search by location name or coordinates, share the map with others in various ways, change the map projection, take a snapshot of the imagery shown on the map, and export imagery in different formats. Lastly, you can click on the I or Information button to provide feedback, go back to the tour stories, change app-wide settings, access notifications, or turn on the distraction-free mode. Click on the check or tick mark on the last step of the blue Introduction to Worldview box, and you'll reach the end of the tour. From here, you can click on More Stories or click on Exit Tutorial. Okay, now we are going to take an in-depth look at all of these features and functionalities that we just covered in the tour story. Let's look at the ways in which you can select your date of interest. You can change the date for your imagery by using the timeline located at the bottom of the app. Either type in a different date or use the up and down arrows above the year, month, and day fields, or the back and forward arrows. You can also use the pick on the timeline to move to another date. Next, we'll show you how to find your area of interest. You can zoom in and out of the map using the zoom buttons, mouse wheel or trackpad, or use location search to pinpoint locations on the map by entering place names or coordinates. Let's type in New Orleans, select it from the drop-down menu, and in the lower left corner, change the date to August 29th, 2021. Once we've done that, you can see it's rather cloudy. Now let's zoom out to see Hurricane Ida, which made landfall that day as a Category 4 storm, and also turn on the MODIS Aqua Corrected Reflectance Layer using the eye icon. Perhaps you'd like to share this image with your colleagues. One way to do this is to take a snapshot of the image and share it with them. Just click on the camera icon in the upper right corner. Adjust the corners of the box to select your area of interest. You can click and hold the box to move around the map. You can select your desired output resolution and output file format. Click on download and save the output image to your computer. Next, we'll show you how to change map projections in Worldview. Let's go back to Worldview and click on the Worldview logo to reset the map to its defaults. Worldview has imagery and three different map projections. Let's first change the date to the previous day using the left arrow to ensure we have a full day's worth of imagery to view. To change the map projection, click on the globe icon in the upper right-hand corner of the app. Here you will notice that in addition to imagery being available on the geographic projection, some of Worldview's satellite imagery layers are also available in polar stereographic projections for the Arctic and Antarctic. Click on the Arctic projection to see a top-down view of the North Pole. You'll see a black hole in the center of the imagery. This is because it's wintertime there and there isn't enough reflected sunlight to provide an image. It's like trying to take a photograph in the dark. Let's go back to the geographic projection and show you where to find those 1,000 plus satellite imagery layers and add some layers to the map. In the layer list on the left, click on the orange Add Layers button at the bottom of the panel. Next, you'll see a window showing different categories of scientific measurements sorted by hazards and disasters, science disciplines, featured, and recent. You can browse through the categories or enter your own keyword in the search bar. You can also do a featured layer search. Access it by clicking on the filter icon or click in the search bar. Here you can see various options to filter the imagery layers. You can filter by coverage, category, measurement, source, period, and whether the layer is a daytime or nighttime layer. Click on the back button to return to the tabs. The featured tab shows off the most widely used layers and the newest layer additions. The recent tab shows layers that you've recently added to the map. Let's click on the featured layers tab and select land surface temperature. Now check the box next to Aqua MODIS land surface temperature day to see land surface temperature measured in Kelvin. Click on the X in the upper right corner to close the layer picker. As you can see, the layer is now in the layer list, and the layers are grouped by measurement to more effectively place similar layer visualization types together, making it easier to manipulate a group rather than individual layers. Hover over Reference and click on the three dots. Click Show All Layers and move the group above land surface temperature. Now you can see place labels on the map. Now we'll show you a few ways in which you can customize the look of certain types of layers, like this land surface temperature layer. You can make changes to the color palettes and thresholds on the layer. Let's click on the View Options icon. This opens an option window where you can change the opacity of the layer, thresholds, and choose from a variety of color palettes. Another setting you can change is the temperature units. Click on the I button in the upper right corner of the app. Click on Settings and a global app-wide settings panel will open. Here you can change the temperature units for all relevant temperature layers loaded in the layer list between Kelvin, Celsius, and Fahrenheit, or keep the defaults. Let's click on Celsius and hover over the red areas of the land surface temperature layer on the map. You can see in the layer list the legend shows the red areas are about 50 degrees Celsius. Okay, now let's go back to the layer list to explore another key feature of Worldview, the Events tab. This tab shows a list of some of the natural events happening around the world. This information has been curated by NASA's Earth Observatory Natural Event Tracker, or EONET for short. You can filter through events by date and type by clicking on the filter icon. Let's click the All button to disable all the events, then turn on only the wildfire events, and change the date to span the month of August. Click Apply. This shows a curated list of all fire events around the world in August. Next, we're going to zoom into California and open the filter panel again. Check the box next to Only List Events in Current Map View and click Apply. This shows a shorter list of events. Let's click on the Caldor fire that started on Monday, August 16, 2021. Here you see a true color MODIS Terra corrected reflectance image showing smoke emanating from the fire. Overlaid on top are orange dots or fire points from the Fires and Thermal Anomalies layer from the MODIS Terra. The polar orbiting satellites take a snapshot of events as they pass over the Earth, so the fire points shown are for a specific time frame. Also, each fire point represents the center of an approximately 1 kilometer pixel, flagged as containing one or more fires or other thermal anomalies such as volcanoes, and are not necessarily the coordinates of the actual fire on the ground. You can click on these fire points to find out more information like fire radiative power, detection confidence, acquisition time, and much more. We can track the fire's development by creating an animation using the animation tool. First, let's close the vector dialog box by clicking on the X in the upper right corner. Let's move down to the lower left portion of the app and click on the video camera icon in the timeline. Worldview will set the time period automatically to 10 days. We are going to change the frames per second to 10 by dragging the center button all the way to the right. Now we'll click play to see the fire spread in those 10 days. You can also click on the loop video button next to the play button to repeat the animation. Also save the animation. Let's export this to an animated GIF. Click on the Create Animated GIF button on the right side of the animation panel. Adjust the box like you did for the image snapshot and then click Create GIF. Worldview will show that it is requesting imagery. Wait for the GIF results window to appear, and then you click on Download to download the animated GIF. When you are done, just close the GIF window. Let's now explore the comparison feature. First, close the animation panel and click back on the Layers tab. Select the Start Comparison button. The Comparison tool allows you to compare the same imagery from different dates, different imagery for the same date, or whatever combination that you like. Once you click on Start Comparison, you'll see the screen split. We are now in the swipe comparison mode. You'll notice that the A side is on the left and the B side is on the right. You can change the dates or imagery shown by selecting the relevant A or B tab in the layer list. Move the center swipe line to the left and right to compare the imagery from the date on the left side and the imagery from the date on the right side. There are also two other comparison modes, Opacity and Spy. Click on Opacity near the orange Add Layers button. This mode fades the imagery between A and B. Click on Spy to see a spyglass superimposed on the imagery. The large map is the A imagery. The spyglass is the B imagery. If you select the B tab in the layer list, the imagery will switch. Click on Exit Comparison to exit out of the comparison tool. Let's take a look at the burn scar from the fire. First, let's change the date to September 5th. Then we'll turn on the corrected reflectance band 721 layer from MODIS Terra. This band combination is good for highlighting burned areas shown as deep or bright red. Click on the ruler icon on the lower right side of the screen next to the scale bar. The measure tool allows you to measure distance and area. Let's try measuring the area of the burn scar. Click on Measure Area. Click to add the first point on one side of the red area. Continue to trace around the perimeter of the burn scar, clicking to add another point each time. Double-click to end the area polygon and to see the estimated size of the burned area. Click back on the ruler icon to change between square miles and square kilometers. And then you can either download the measurements as a GeoJSON so you can open the measurement polygon in your own GIS client, or click Remove Measurements to remove the measurements from the map. In addition to being able to share a snapshot and an animated GIF of your imagery with your colleagues, you can also share a shortened link to your map view so that they can interact directly with the imagery themselves. Click on the Share This Map icon in the upper right corner. On the Link tab, it'll populate a URL that will save all of your presets from the map. You can also click on Shorten Link to provide a shorter, more readable and shareable link. Click on Copy next to the URL and open a new tab. Paste the URL there to view the same map you were looking at earlier. You can even embed Worldview on your own web page, in a story map or other web-based product. All you have to do is click on Share This Map, then the Embed tab, and copy that code to your web page. If you need more help embedding, click on the documentation URL to find out more information on how to embed maps. From here, you can also click on the Examples of Embedded Worldview page to see live examples of how you might want to use the embed feature, such as this first one about comparing imagery from two different dates. Click on the icon in the upper right corner of the embedded map to open this worldview map in a new tab. Let's return to our previous worldview map. For many of the layers in Worldview, you can also download the underlying data. So let's click on the Data tab in the Layer list. Click on the Radio button next to the data set you'd like to download. Check the Set Area of Interest box to draw a bounding box around the specific area. Click the orange Download via Earth Data Search button, then click the Continue button to be taken to Earth Data Search to download the data sets. Let's go back to Worldview and uncheck the Set Area of Interest box so that we can get back to the map. Lastly, if you think the interface is looking a little cluttered, click on the I button in the upper right corner to turn on distraction-free mode. You can get rid of the layer list, timeline, measure tool, and other buttons so you can concentrate on the imagery. We hope you have enjoyed your tour of NASA Worldview's key features and functionalities. Now get out there and start exploring for yourselves at worldview.earthdata.nasa.gov. Thank you.